So my first question for you would be to describe your role in HubMap.
My role in HubMap is to lead one of the mapping centers. I think one of the things that's exciting about HubMap is we're going to be generating so much data from so many different types of tissues. There'll be data from the heart, there'll be data from the spleen, there'll be data from the lung. And it won't even just be one type of data. There'll be imaging data, there'll be sequencing data, there'll be an extraordinary diversity of data sets that we're going to have access to. On one hand, it's wonderful to have so much diversity in the data that we're looking at. On the other hand, as biologists, we want ways to be able to interpret and reference and compare these different data to each other. And one of the best ways to be able to do that is to have some sort of reference framework, to be able to have a language or an ontology or a vocabulary that we can use to describe these different types of data. And that's really the goal of the mapping centers that are part of Hive. I lead one of them, and Katie Borner at Indiana leads the other. And what we're really trying to do is we're trying to build dictionaries or vocabularies or references that we can use to describe all the data that's eventually going to be generated as part of HubMap.
My question is, what is SORA? Like, what does it do? And then where does the name come from?
Yeah. So SORA is a software toolkit. It's a piece of software that's been developed by my lab. And actually, it started when I was a postdoc. The very first pieces of code I developed when I was a postdoc in Aviv Regev's lab. Aviv is also a member of HubMap. But now it's a software package that I maintain in collaboration with the PhD students, postdocs, and staff in my lab. And the purpose of Serratus is to provide a piece of software that researchers, whether it's from our own lab or hopefully from any lab, can take single-cell data and interpret their data with this computational program. So when you generate a single-cell data set, there are many questions that you might have. You might wonder if the cells fall into different clusters. You might ask which individual genes or which individual sequences each cell contains. There are a variety of common questions which are really unifying to the single cell field. And those are questions that we hope that researchers can help answer by using SORAT. SORAT is an R toolkit that helps users to explore, analyze, and interpret their single cell data.
Great, thank you. I have another question more about focused on the users. So who exactly is using SORAT and why?
SORAT is very widely used across the community. We see about 25,000 people download the software every month. And it's quite, we hope it's a very wide variety of users who are able to access the software. Those would include PhD students and postdocs in academic labs, but also researchers in industry and government labs as well. We've tried to make the software accessible to a very wide group of people. So that would include people who have a predominantly computational background, who are very interested in using advanced analytical algorithms. But we also aim to have the software to be accessible and used by people who are just starting out in single-cell analysis and who may not have had a lot of computational experience before, but still need to have a way to be able to analyze and explore their data. So we hope to be able to reach a wide user base because all of those groups of people are generating single-cell data and are interested in the insights that can be derived from looking at it.
Thanks so much. So I want to zoom out a little bit for the next question. And I would like to know, what exactly is data harmonization and why is it necessary?
We've previously discussed some of the big challenges for HubMap, and one of the big challenges is taking many, many different and diverse data sets and interpreting them together. So I'll give you an example of why data harmonization is so important. Let's say that you're doing an experiment on the human heart, and you're looking at cells in the human heart. There are many different types of technologies that you can run to profile those cells. For example, you can use a sequencing technology, for example, single-cell RNA-seq. And what that technology does is it asks what DNA or RNA sequences are present in each cell at any one time. So it's really a molecular profile, a very high resolution molecular profiling of that cell. On the other hand, you might also use an imaging approach. You might use a microscope, or you might use a spatial profiling technology that allows you to take a picture of that cell and understand where it's actually located. If you use that sort of approach, you might get much less information. You might not know as much about the genes that are present in that particular cell. But you'll know something more about its spatial location and its shape and its morphology. So these are very, very different types of data, right? But fundamentally, they must be linked somehow because they're both being generated from the heart. So we don't want to be able to interpret them completely on their own. We want to be able to understand how they fit together. And if we can understand how they fit together, then we can understand how the molecular content of a cell also influences its spatial location and its morphology and its function. So the goal of data harmonization is being able to take multiple data sets which share some common underlying features and being able to interpret them in a single downstream analysis. And that is really one of the most exciting and difficult challenges for HubMap.
Thank you. And since you just mentioned HubMap, so how has Sorat been used for HubMap or for the HubMap portal so far?
So there are two particular areas in which we're excited about deploying Sorat, both now and in the future of HubMap. The first is a complex problem which we call cell annotation. So we have many, many different types of cells in the body, of course, and we'd like to be able to give them a name, right? We'd like to be able to say this is a neuron, or this is a skin cell, or this is a fibroblast, or this is a T cell, or of course, this could be a different subset of T cells or a subset of macrophages. We'd like to be able to name cells. And importantly, we want to be able to do that in a consistent and uniform way across all of the HubMap data sets that we generate. We don't want to have individual names for individual data sets. We want to be able to use a consistent and common naming framework. And that's a process that we call cell annotation. And you can imagine that in order to be able to have consistent and uniform names across many different data sets, that is fundamentally a problem for data harmonization. And so that's one of the key areas that we're excited about, is being able to annotate and name cells in a consistent way across HubMap. A second and very related problem is how can we visualize all of these data together in one common space? So many of you, if you're watching these videos, will be familiar hopefully with the HubMap portal, which is a way that you can visualize, explore, and interact with HubMap data. As I mentioned, there'll be hundreds and eventually thousands of experiments that are generated as part of HubMap. And what we'd like to be able to do is to enable you to visualize and interact with those experiments in a harmonized way, not necessarily having to click on 1,000 individual links and look at 1,000 individual analyses, but to be able to, example, pool all the data sets together from an organ to be able to look at a single integrated and harmonized visualization and downstream analysis. So that's another feature that's enabled by our software and which we hope will be very useful for HubMap going forward.
Thanks so much, Rahul. And that brings me to the last question, which is, how can I, just as a single user, use Sorat?
So Sorat is a fully open source software package. So all of our code and documentation are freely available for you to access. You can go to my lab website, satijalab.org, or just search for Sorat in Google, and hopefully you'll be able to find it. And you'll find a few things. The first is a link to our GitHub page, which contains all of our code and also instructions to install the software on your personal computer or server. But we also have a series of documentations, tutorials, and vignettes, which are basically ways that we think we can help you get started with analyses, particularly if you haven't worked with analyzing single cell data before. They're sort of guided analyses where we walk you through a data set that's in the literature that can kind of illustrate the types of commands and analyses that you might want to run on your own data when performing a single cell analysis. So we hope that all that documentation and vignettes can help a new user kind of familiarize themselves both with Sorat, but also with single cell analysis in general.